The Empire 8's top-rated passing offense proved to be no match for Fisher, with the Cardinals cruising to a 42-13 win over Hartwick last week. Fisher jumped out to a 28-0 lead at halftime and did not look back. Tyler Fenty threw for 280 yards and 2 touchdowns. Wideout Mike Colicchio made 6 catches for 82 yards and a touchdown. And running back Tony Fusco ran for 69 yards and 2 touchdowns on 12 carries. Linebacker Sean Price led the defensive unit with 8 tackles and 2 sacks. Despite the convincing win, Fisher drops 1 spot to number 16 in this week's D3Football.com Top 25. Meanwhile, Ithaca's loss to Buffalo State was enough to drop them from number 13 to out of the top 25 altogether. The loss by Ithaca creates a 3-way tie atop the Empire 8 Conference standings, with the Cardinals, Bombers, and Bengals all with 3-1 records in conference play. This week's opponent will be the Utica College Pioneers. After starting 4-0 overall and 2-0 in conference play for the first time in program history, Utica has dropped 2 in a row, including a 36-19 loss to Salisbury last week. The Pioneers have never beaten the Cardinals in 13 prior matchups, but Fisher survived a scare last year, winning 28-27 on the strength of 3 touchdowns in the final 5 minutes 11 seconds of the first half to rally from a 20-point deficit and post the biggest comeback win in program history.
They're a very good football team. They're good in all areas of their game, well-coached, and they will be a problem again this year.
Offensively, they got Acevedo, a wide receiver. What threats does he pose for them?
Well, he's probably he may be the premier receiver in Division III football this year. I mean, he's a big, strong kid, and he's got speed. So he's a tough young man to handle, and you just got to look at the games he's played and how many yards he's got and so on. He's tough, and he will present a problem, no doubt about it.
Utica defensive end Nick Woodman is the Empire 8 leader in sacks with 5.5 heading into action this weekend. So a key for Fisher will be how well the offensive line protects their quarterback. The line has allowed 8 sacks through the first 5 games, and with Utica having the conference's second-ranked defense against the pass, Tyler Fenty will have to rely on his linemen as he leads the Empire 8's top-scoring offense into battle.
If we stick to our assignments, do what we're taught, I mean, we shouldn't have a problem with them. Stay on our tracks, pick them up. He slants inside, we'll have someone else pick him up.
Well, I think it's all about trust. We all trust each other that they'll get the job done. The guy next to you will do a great job. And we go over all week in practice. We've been focusing a lot on number 21 and how we're going to lock him down. So I think we're going to do a good job at it.
Fisher and Utica will renew acquaintances on the campus of Utica College this Saturday afternoon at 1. For those not making the trip, you can stay connected to the game in many ways. Dan Borello and Peter Montemurno will have live audio for ESPN Rochester, starting with the pregame show at 12:30. Utica College will provide live streaming video of the game on their website, ucpioneers.com. The game will also be broadcast on Time Warner Cable Sports Channel. Check your local listings. And you can join the conversation on social media, Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram, #GoFisher. And by signing up for free SMS alerts to your wireless device at athletics.sjfc.edu. Message and data rates may apply.